You're going to have some technical difficulty. All right. I want to welcome you all. Thank you for spending this, you know, Saturday evening with us. We really, truly, you know, appreciate that fact that everybody came out for a very important task, and we get to know the candidates. You know, voting is our right. We should vote. We should vote when we are informed. And these sessions are done to inform the audience what the candidates are going to bring for you. The candidates are picked not just for one community or the other. The candidates are picked for everybody in the community. And that's what we need to ask questions about. That's what we need to prepare. And that's what we need to hear today. So saying that, to put a platform together, BIA, which is Voice of Indian American Voters, did a platform idea which was amazing, that bringing every candidate who's running in the town, in the city, and the state. This is our second BIA event. First, we did it in Chicago with Chicago mayors, and the second is here in Schaumburg, and third, we're going to do it for Naperville, which is tomorrow. So the idea is to give the candidates a platform and have them introduce themselves, and we get to know, so we are making the informed decision to vote. So I want to really thank the founders of BIA and invite them to the podium to say a few words. Dr. Anuja Gupta, Dr. Brad Rai, Dr. Sanjeev. Why not? I mean, right. Dr. Sanjeev.
That makes you feel much better now. one software engineer between two doctors. So first of all, thank you so much for all the people from our community who have come here. And along with that, I would like to welcome all our village president candidates and village trustee candidates. Definitely it shows that you all care for Indian American community. You have given us time to come and share your views that what and why we should vote for our community should vote for you, and what you can do for our city of Schaumburg. So thank you so much, and I'd like to give a big round of applause for all.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Anuja Gupta, one of the co-founders of the Voice of Indian American Voters. Our organization is a nonpartisan platform that we started because we thought we could increase the engagement of our community in the election and the voting process. The top goals of our organization are to present a stronger voice, to seek a better level of engagement with public officials, and to increase the participation of our community in the election and the voting process. Welcome again, and we look forward to getting to really know the candidates today. Thank you.
So before we begin the program, we would like to invite our event chair, Mr. Nimish Jani, to please come on stage and share his views.
Thank you, Sanjeev Bhai. Thank you, Dr. Gupta. I am taking liberty on behalf of Schaumburg resident to give honorary doctorate degree to Sanjeev. Joke is finished. Indian American community is young, vibrant, thriving, very successful community in United States. Majority of Indians migrated about 50 years ago. That's where I would say our pioneer came, settlers came, founders came. In Illinois, it was used to be Devon, Lawrence, and some other area. Once they grew, they become more successful, they move out. Park Ridge, Des Plaines, Morton Grove. However, all those areas were kind of part of Chicago City. Close to Chicago City, I should say that. Then they thought that new emerging suburb, let's move there. And Schaumburg and surrounding area was their choice. So after Chicago, what would be the best area to host this event, which is Schaumburg? I'm very proud and happy to be a part of this organization, and I truly appreciate and thank to everyone, not only come on a very busy schedule. I know many individuals who has a conflict today, and yet they came. So thank you very much to be a part of this event. Thank you again.
Thank you, everybody. You know, the perception is out there. Indian major in medical field or in IT. So Sanjeev Bhai is in IT. You know, the perception, I want to make that concrete right now. Yeah, we are. I want to invite mayor candidates. This is how the format will be today. We'll first invite the mayor candidates for 45 minutes. We'll have a Q&A. And we'll invite trustees right after that. And we'll have 45 minutes for the trustee as well. So I want to go ahead and invite mayoral candidates. Please step on the stage. Tom, Daly, Nafiz Rahman, Matt.
Yes, sir.
All right. He's a senior in our community. We got to listen to Suresh Bhai sometimes, and he'll get upset. Okay. All right. So just some rules I wanted to put it ahead of time. So for mayors, we'll ask 5 questions, and we'll give 1 minute for each candidate to respond. 15 seconds before your minute finishes, you will hear a ding. Go ahead. Is it loud and clear? And once your 60 seconds are up, you will hear, you're done. So let's respect everybody's time and make sure, and let's respect who's holding that bell is my daughter, Alina, Fatima, and Ayan Hussaini. If you want to take the bell off, stand up. We're doing a very important role today. And in our household, we all listen to her, so please. So there are some consequences. She will stand up. So to start the session, question and answers for mayors, I want to start with the first question, very generic, high level. You can break it down as much as you want. And we will start with
Nafiz. Do you want to do the opening so people?
Okay, and you know what? Sorry about that. I do want them to say something before we get started. So 2 minutes, we are going to give them, each mayor candidate, 1 minute actually, to represent themselves as to what they stand for and everything else, so you can get to know, and then we will ask Q&A later on. So let them introduce themselves. If you could just turn down that mic, we'll start with you.
All right. First of all, salam, namaste, sashariyakal to everybody. This is a diverse group of people that represent Schaumburg. My name is Nafiz Rahman. I'm running for the village president of Schaumburg. I've been living in Schaumburg for the past 23 years. I have a BA degree from DePaul and an MBA from Lake Forest Graduate School of Management. I'm currently working for Illinois Secretary of State, the Honorable Jesse White, as a deputy director in accounting revenue, where I managed $2.5 billion for the secretary. Previously, I was a chief executive officer for the third largest office supply manufacturing company. I've traveled all over the US and most of the countries in the world. I shouldn't say I've traveled everywhere, but I've seen a lot.
I was born and raised here in Schaumburg, lived here for 40 years, so youngest candidate, but longest resident.
I would speak more to my biography, but it is on the card in front of you, and it's also on my website, stewardforschaumburg.com, that is on that card. Today, I actually want to both introduce myself through the questions and answers that we have the opportunity to engage the community with, but also to tell you reasons why you should vote for me as your next village president of Schaumburg. And there's actually six, but I'll go through them quickly. There's three things I'm the only one talking about, and there's three things I'm the first candidate to talk about. The three things I'm the first to talk about, I better go quick, assess our staffing needs, equal pay for equal work, and a volunteer diversity commission. The three things I'm the only one talking about is bringing a tech hub startup to the old Dominic site, keeping video gaming out, and thank you.
Good afternoon. Since moving to Schaumburg 36 years ago, I have made it my goal to help my community become the best place to live, work, and play, and raise a family. I started working on my goal by volunteering to be on my homeowners association, and then being appointed to numerous committees, eventually being appointed to the Zoning Board of Appeals before deciding to run for trustee. Now I'm running for mayor because I believe with my 30 years of dedication and commitment, Schaumburg needs a mayor that has the knowledge and experience and proven leadership to lead us into the future. I've been preparing for this for the last 30 years by making connections with local officials and building relationships. Over the last 8 years, Schaumburg has reduced the property tax burden on its residents and businesses by 17%. No other community can make that claim. As mayor, I will continue to reduce the tax burden by reducing taxes another 5% in the first year. My priority is to continue to make Schaumburg a prosperous community for residents and businesses alike, knowing that their investments are growing and Schaumburg is the place to be.
Everybody is respecting the time, each other's time, and thank you so much for introducing yourself. When we were leaving the house, I told Alina that we're going to do this and we're going to keep everybody's time, and she said, "Dad, can I do this for you too?" No, you're not going to do it for the moderator. You're going to do it for only mayoral candidate, okay? And Trustee Ayan, you will
do it.
All right.
All right. So let's get started. Without further ado, our first question from the BIA committee are two questions. First two questions. So we'll talk about that. First is a high level question. We're just talking about in generic as to how well do you know Schaumburg current financials, strengths and weaknesses, and how would you add to it in positive way? And we'll start with Tom.
Well, of course, I've been a trustee for the last actually 4.5 years. I was off the board for 4 years, and then I was on 20 years prior to that. So I'm very familiar. Numbers are the thing I'm involved in. I do run an IT department for another community, so I like numbers. Schaumburg is in very good financial condition. Contrary to what you'll hear, we do not have any kind of financial situation. We've been a AAA rated bond community for the last 30 years. We've had a balanced budget all 30 years. Yes, we do have some debt. Everybody has debt. How many people have a mortgage? How many have a car payment? How many have credit cards? We all carry debt. It's not unusual. Schaumburg's debt is under control, and it is accounted for. We have dedicated revenue sources for all of Schaumburg's debt. Thank you.
I too am familiar with Schaumburg, having not only lived there my entire life, but also I do currently sit on the Old Schaumburg Center Commission, that is a downtown preservation district. I also happen to work for and help run the budget and finances of a major loop law firm that has a budget roughly the same size, $250 million, as the Village of Schaumburg. I am aware of pros and cons with Schaumburg. I love the community, that's why I want to be the village president, but some of the pros, as Tom mentioned, the AAA rating is a great thing for our
our credit rating. One of the cons is, I know that a couple years ago in 2017, Moody's recommended that be downgraded to AA. It wasn't, it's still AAA, and I'm proud of that, as I know Tom is as well. But we do have $385 million worth of debt. Once you add on interest, that becomes $464 million. On top of that, last year's budget ran an $11 million deficit. These are fiscally responsible areas that I want to steward us better into the future. Thank you.
I believe most pressing issue Schaumburg is facing is tremendous level of debt, okay? I don't understand why there's a denial in debt. There is over $200 million in debt. I'm sorry, plus $200 million in debt, okay? That debt comes from perhaps bad decision that we have made in the past. And moving forward, I think we need to reduce the debt. We need to make sure the debt is alleviated before we make other investments. There is another investment that we were talking about parking debt. That's another $33 million investment. Parking debt does not make any sense at this juncture. And the reason for that is, who's gonna pay for it? We don't have funding to pay for that parking debt. Is that a warning or is this?
15 seconds.
Okay. So, as a, you know, and we want to talk more about the debt issue in Schaumburg. We want to talk about where we lose money and. Sorry.
All right. Thank you, everyone. The second question is, what do you think about commercial property occupancy rate in Schaumburg? What are your plans to improve that? So let's start with Nafis and go Matt and Tom.
Okay. Chicago Magazine in 2019, 12 million square feet of office space is available according to Office Finder. Okay. In Schaumburg is there. We have a lot of openings for the offices. What we need to do is, many of our younger generation is working downtown. Somehow we need to bring them back to Schaumburg. We need to appeal, we need to get technology companies in Schaumburg. So all the younger generation starts to come into Schaumburg and work in Schaumburg. And also, in addition to that, we need to give some incentive to those businesses. Lowering our taxes is number one. Our tax ratio is extremely high in Schaumburg, and we have mentioned that in my previous platform. Our agenda is to lower the business taxes so we can attract more businesses in Schaumburg. Thank you.
We sit at a relatively low retail vacancy rate of about 7%, but when you factor in commercially available space for all kinds of commercial industry, it's higher at 27% per the Cook County Treasurer's Office. The other problem with our vacancy rates are that these are in high visibility areas. So I know Discovery Office Park is going bankrupt. I know that the old Dominic's at Roselle and Schaumburg Roads has been a quagmire for some time. The problem there, as many are aware, but maybe not all, is that the land is owned by somebody else, while a lease that runs with the land is owned by Albertsons, who owns Jewel and has no interest of a grocery store being there. I actually propose that we need to find a short-term lease, somebody who has the appetite for a short-term lease. I think that would be a great place for a tech startup hub for apps or websites to go in there on a short-term basis, hopefully grow their companies. When a grocery store comes in, they've already moved on. Thank you.
So, of course, every community has vacancies. It's not unexpected. Schaumburg's vacancy rates actually are somewhat in line, although our commercial space is a little distorted right now because we have Zurich, who moved into a new building, vacated one of the towers over there on Meacham. You've also got, as pointed out already, the Dominic's. There's a Lowe's that Big Box sits over in Barrington that's empty, and those are distorting our numbers. So our vacancy rates are not as high as actually being projected. One of the things I find interesting is, here's an article that was out of BizHub, and it's four reasons why Schaumburg is the hottest market for real estate in the suburbs. And there's a reason for that. It's because Schaumburg is a great place to live, and a great place to be, and businesses want to be here. You're all here because you're concerned. You either live here or you have a business or both, and you think this is the place to be. And I think this is just a small anomaly that will pass over the next year.
All right, thank you. All right, this third question is from our audience, Ken Battelle. And Matt, I'll start with you on this question, and we'll go to Tom, and we'll go to Nafis.
I was surprised
looking at the stat
here with
Indian audience, Indian residents in Schaumburg is 23 to 24%. That's a quarter of Schaumburg. That's a high number that I thought it would be 10-15, but honest with you, but researching
this
kind of gave us a perspective as well,
looking at Schaumburg
differently. So 23 to 24%. So the question was positioned as, how do you plan to engage Indian American community in the village? I'll start with you, Matt, and Tom, and then Teresa.
Thank you for the question, and I am not surprised, actually. I knew it was at least at 20%, so good to hear that it's even higher. I know that the business owner percentage is also higher, and
that's
a group that we need to not lose focus of or lose sight of either. One of the ways I want to engage, I've already been engaged with many of my old friends and family connections that are in the community from having lived here as long as I do, so I know very many people in the community. But one other area I want to engage with them in is the issues that matter most to this community. And I know that for other communities it might be property taxes or vacancies on stores, but for this community, crime is an actual issue. And there's been an increase in crime, especially around wedding times when there's jewels and cash in the house, and those houses are being broken into. I want to work on our police shortage and figure out solutions to that so that we can address the crime in the community. Thank you.
Well, I'm unaware of some of the things you're talking about with crime and police, but anyway, I agree. I thought the rate was around 20%, so I think we're pretty close one way or another. Anyway, what I think is we need to have better representation of the community, of the Indian community within the village. The village has not done that very well. We do have diversity with women. We have plenty of women, especially in the executive positions. 6 out of 8 are women, and I think we need more from the Indian community. I'd also like to establish, I mentioned this before, we have a sister cities with a community from India, and establish that using an advisory group here that are pulled from businesses and residents within the community to see what we can do better.
Thank you. I concur with Matt. There was a huge crime in the past 2 years in the Indian, in my subdivision. Every other house was robbed. And so we need to inflate our police department. I know there's quite a few police officers are leaving. We need to start strategizing that right now. We want to bring our community to serve in IT. We do a phenomenal job in IT. We need to create an advisory board and get them into the village. We need to diversify the village. In addition to our Asian population, we have 11% Hispanics in the area. We have 5% African American. We need to be inclusive. Right now, it seems like we are very exclusive, and we need to have inclusion come into the place. So I would recommend that, you know, we look forward and bring our inclusivity to the village hall, which represents our community. Thank you.
All right, the fourth question is about finance, but a little bit more about what your plans are. So this is from the audience as well. How do you plan to put Schaumburg on a firm financial footage? What are your plans for that? So we'll start with Tom.
Okay, well, I believe that Schaumburg is on a solid financial footing, and I mentioned that before. We have balanced budgets. We do a lot of repairs. We have a $110 million operating budget and about $140 million in capital improvements. However, I do think that we need to change our priorities a little bit with the capital. I think we need to spend more on our streets. We've let our streets get behind, and we need to do more repairs to streets. So I want to strengthen that by taking $2 million in that capital and dedicated $2 million additional and dedicated for streets. That's very important to be done. I also plan to reduce the village portion of the property tax by 5%. And that's certainly doable to be done for my first year.
I too agree with Tom on both the lowering the property taxes and improving the roads, but to do both of those things, we need to either increase revenue or decrease costs elsewhere. One of the ways I want to increase revenue is to start, and this is not going to be much at first, but down the road, taxing charging stations so that electronic vehicles are paying the same type of usage taxes that fuel taxpayers are paying for fuel vehicles. I also want to make sure that we have those storefronts we talked about earlier filled so that we get more of our share of the sales tax. As far as reducing spending, I think we need to also look at our staffing issues. We have a lot of turnover at the lower levels that is quite frankly expensive when you have a lot of turnover at lower levels of staff. And at the higher levels, we're a little top heavy in our supervisor staff positions, and so I want to look at that. One thing I want to add from the last question real quick with my extra time is, in my opening I mentioned I want to have a volunteer diversity commission that would be for all communities, and so I want to stress that as well.
Thank you. All right. Thank you. Again, we need to build relationships. We need to benchmark other villages who are doing phenomenal. Naperville is one. The mayor of Naperville has reduced the taxes significantly. They were in $120 million debt, and he came out of it. So I want to benchmark Naperville and look at other successful suburbs who are doing the same thing. We need to reduce business taxes to attract more businesses, small businesses. Our community, as much as they're engaged in the business, they're scared about the taxes, and our taxes are one of the highest in the next suburbs if you look at within the vicinity. We want to build relationships with businesses. We want to attract businesses into Schaumburg. We want to talk about corporate 500, from corporate 100, Fortune 100 businesses, bring them into Schaumburg, give them incentives. Biggest thing is to lowering taxes in our village for businesses.
I hope audience are getting some information and getting some concrete decisions as to what you're going to do at the voting poll. So this is for you, and we want to open it for the audience right now to ask one question. Please raise your hand. So raise, Jane, raise your hand first. So.
I'm Raisi Yavor. My question is, what specific plans do you have to ensure public safety, and how will you keep your residents, especially students, safe from gun violence? Did you want me to say
anything?
So,
oh. We'll start with Nafis.
Yes. What specific plans do you have to ensure public safety, and how will you keep your residents, specifically students, safe from gun violence?
Thank you,
Reese. First of all, again, my concern about police officers. We need to hire more police officers and patrol the area most frequently. Okay. Secondly, gun violence. I completely concur with our current Congressman Raja Krishnamurthy. He wants to put some buffer for people who get guns, okay? We want to focus on mental awareness from high school students. They're under a lot of stress. My daughter goes to a high school and I see how much stress they're in. So we need to put together a strategy and a program where the high school kids who are mentally stressed have somewhere to go and talk to.
I come from a family with two special needs siblings, and so mental health and mental health awareness and access to mental health care is a high priority for my family. And that's kind of one of the root causes of these gun violence incidents. I know I mentioned earlier upping the police force, but I also have some other concrete ideas I want. I know Tom Dork has recently started a task force after the shooting in Aurora. I think that Schaumburg should be represented on that task force, and I would get us involved as much as we're able to within the means of our budget and make room for more of that. I also want to keep out, and I'm the only candidate who wants to keep out video gaming. Other candidates might say, it's not a problem in other communities yet. I don't want to be a problem in our community ever. And there's a variety of other reasons on my website, because I'm limited for time, as to why I want to keep out video gaming and why I think we're too late for that market anyway. We're not going to make a whole lot off of it. And so that is one other area I strongly feel opposed to, actually. Thank you.
So Schaumburg has been very proactive when it comes to helping cheering our children. There is they call them a community resource officer, but they're a police officer that's based in the Schaumburg High School. And I know Hoffman Estates does the same thing. So if you have children at Conant or at Hoffman High, same thing. We also have deployed officers into the junior highs now. So you'll see them there. And I know that when they're on patrol, the patrol officer for that area stops in at the school at least once a day. They're supposed to go twice, once in the morning, once in the afternoon. So they try and ensure that they're around and there's a visibility, a presence of a patrol car there. That's somewhat they do. They also work with the staff of both the high school and the grade school to do drills and things of that nature. They also do it at Woodfield. But they do that so that helps ensure that. And with my son as a Schaumburg police officer, I can guarantee you that is being done.
All right, thank you. Well, I want to take a moment and say to this to the candidates, thank you so much for keeping the time the way you guys are doing and stopping. I saw the Schaumburg Mayoral debate, and I was really scared that time is nothing. That guy was standing and waving and doing everything, and nobody was stopping. So just think, and thank you for keeping the time, both of you, not just because you are my kids. You're doing a great job. All right, so for the sixth question, Nimish, do you want to pose the question?
So, I'm okay. Everybody can hear me?
Yes.
Thank you. I think a couple of questions were not answered properly. I was going to ask a question, but I thought it's better to a resident who was born and brought up, educated in Schaumburg, should ask that question. So I would like to invite Anil Baro to come to the stage and ask questions. Anil, please.
Nimishri, thank you very much.
Thank you for the kind introductions. So let me do this without the mic. So as a resident of Schaumburg for over 20 years, let me take this back to all the candidates here. As it was mentioned earlier, I was raised in the state of Illinois, had the opportunity to visit all over the world, and worked for Motorola for over 20 years in various capacities with my good friend Nor back there. And I've had the opportunity through various other activities to meet significant political leaders, whether it be Democrats, Republicans, or Independents, across the Illinois, across the U.S. So I've got really three questions, okay? And the first question I have is, when my parents settled here from India, from Gujarat, they settled in, we started out in Chicago, moved to Niles, moved to Elk Grove, then we moved to Schaumburg. It was a natural progression. And they came here for three prime reasons. One was education, safety, and an inviting climate and culture. Because it was word of mouth. My mom would talk to her friends, say, well, why don't you move to Schaumburg? It's a nice area, people are very nice. It's inviting, there's no crime, there's no, you know, bad element here. So when I look forward and I fast forward, question number one, we all talked about the crime piece, but when I seriously look at Schaumburg today, it's not well represented with the Indian community. When I go out and meet with the mayor of Bartlett, when I go out and meet with the mayor of Streamwood, Hanover Park, they will pick up our phone in an instance. Not just mine, but people from the community. And that's been lacking in this community. So what I want to understand is, what is really your plan? Because I hear people say we're going to set up an advisory board. And I have someone that I have called three times who's actually a very high-level position. He promised me he was going to set up an advisory board, and he has yet to set up that advisory board. So it's one thing to say you're going to do it. The other thing is to say, I take an oath, I'm really going to do it. Because we hear a lot of promises. The execution, the say-do ratio is very less. People say a lot, but they don't follow through. So I want to understand, what is your plan for rural community engagement? Because when you look at it, you have to look at the Indian community not as the residents, but very law-abiding residents. They are very hardworking and believe in strong education, but they've also invested in this community, invested in terms of homes and also businesses. So I'd like to get some background on how you feel, how you're going to engage us in the community going forward.
Thank you. Great question. Let me start by saying this. I work for a guy who's got all the community engaged. It's Honorable Jesse White. Whether you're Hispanic, African American, Asian, he's got everybody engaged, okay? We have created an Asian Advisory Council, and there are a lot of Asian Advisory Council members are here who participate in his Advisory Council. We want to do the same. His theory is to provide customer service on every level. When you take a responsibility, you need to fulfill those responsibilities. And I have that in me now to see how Secretary of State has done his job and how committed he is for all the communities. He's got soft heart for everyone. And I want to do the same thing for our community and make sure that when I make a commitment, I fulfill my commitment. Thank you.
You know, on my cards in front of you, there are three platform points that sound like fluff, I will admit. They're inclusion, transparency, and responsiveness. But I mean, with all my heart, each one of those. I believe we need more inclusion of all the voices in Schaumburg. We need more responsiveness to those voices, and we need transparency about how that is being done. That is why I did propose that volunteer diversity commission that I mentioned before. Then I would actually enforce it and have it in place. If you look up diversity now on the current village website, you'll get no results. There's not, the word diversity doesn't really exist much. I want to change that, and I would do so day one. I know it doesn't look like it, but I used to lead diversity programming at my college and then my law school, and I'm very familiar with the need to continue this conversation. So I thank you very much for your question, and I want to bring this back so that we can keep a well-educated, safe, and welcoming community in Schaumburg. So thank you for your questions.
So, you know, I may not want to hear the word advisory, but that's what my intent is to do, is to use an advisory group. I don't have all the answers. I don't know. I've been out knocking on doors. I've been talking to business people here, and I get the impression that, you know, they love being here. They love Schaumburg, but they don't feel included, and we need to figure that out. We need to understand how that can happen. So I do intend to set up an advisory group. It's going to be made up of people from the Indian community that can help me understand that and help me determine how we do that. Schaumburg has a sister cities program, and we need to establish one. We need to pick one that will work the best for the community, and we can establish a sister cities advisory group there. The other one is staffing. We don't have the diversity in the staffing, and that's a matter of working with HR and saying we need to be more, the staff needs to more represent what the community makeup is.
Gentlemen, thank you. All relevant answers. I know you're all equally well qualified and will do a great job. As you move fast forward, going forward, the last question I have in the interest of time is if you fast forward this and hit the, for those of us that grew up on the 8-track tape era, not the CD era, but if you hit the double fast forward, I guess you can do that on YouTube these days, and you fast forward this 12 months from now, how do you see your administration bringing in economic prosperity into Schaumburg in terms of, you mentioned startups, but to bring a startup here is a lot of, is very different. Having been in a startup and raised a startup, most all the startups are down in merchandise marks. What's your plan to bring in that capital, independent of Governor J.B. Pritzker or at the state level? what private money do you think you can bring in to help infuse the capital and the business that will then bring in other businesses?
Help them spread the word and attract other businesses to come to the village. You know, we don't have to worry about attracting the Motorolas and all that. We have to worry about the small businesses in Schaumburg. That's the heart of Schaumburg, is all the little shops and all the little businesses, the mom and pop places that are keeping Schaumburg going. And that's what I want. That's what I'm worried about, and I want to keep going. I've talked about potentially doing a grant program to help them out in investments. We'll see if that can happen.
Thank you. Great question again. Number one, lowering business taxes that will attract businesses into Schaumburg. Okay. I'm all for small businesses. We have lost a lot of businesses, but we want to go back and attract small businesses. Improve our customer service at the village level. Improve the permit situation that takes so long for business folks to get their business started in Schaumburg. Create a business council, which we can invite Asian, Hispanics, and African American, and cohesively start to strategize what's missing in Schaumburg. One big concern that I have, which I have seen, malls are shrinking, okay? Stratford Mall is a ghost town. We need to start worrying about Woodfield Mall. I'm not trying to scare people, but those are the things that we need to look ahead and start forming a group and strategy how we are going to fulfill that revenue loss. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, all of you. That was a very good response to his spontaneous question. Thank you, Ayo, for posing that question. Thank you. Hello?
Can you please tell them not to talk about that?
Well, I need some new batteries there, I guess, but I hope you can hear me now. I just wanted to thank the candidate for answering that spontaneous question, and thank you for posing that question. And that was really interactive from the audience to ask that question on the spot, and for you guys to answer it. I want to give 1 minute to each candidate for closing remarks. Starting with
thank you. First of all, I want to thank Bia for having us here and all the audience for participating in this event. Ladies and gentlemen, I am a qualified person to be your next president of Schaumburg. I will significantly reduce your municipal taxes, reduce unnecessary spending, embrace our community's diversity, establish residency program for the top village employees, create opportunities for small businesses and for their growth, increase efficiency throughout the village, improve customer service. We have serious issues in Schaumburg with outrageous spending. Budget has increased $50 million in the last 5 years. Poor customer service, no bid contracts, commercial real estate vacancies. You have an opportunity today to make that change and bring somebody new, some fresh ideas, some fresh faces. I would like to thank you.
My opposition has attempted to have you believe Schaumburg is in deep financial debt and in trouble. Nothing could be further from the truth. We have the highest credit rating for Moody's and have a balanced budget every year for the last 30 years. Their view is one of negativity. My view is one of believing that Schaumburg has become that wonderful place where businesses have come to invest and people have come to work, play, and raise a family. That was my goal so many years ago. But I believe Schaumburg is made up of more than just bricks and mortar and blacktop and concrete. It's a wonderful, made up of wonderful shops and restaurants and small businesses that serve our every need. It is made up of hardworking and dedicated people like yourselves wanting to live in the finest community possible. Your choice is simple. Vote for someone that finds fault with everything Schaumburg does and has become, or vote for someone that is proud of what Schaumburg is and will continue to be.
As a proud resident of Schaumburg, I want you all in this room to just get to know me. I'm a positive person. I have a great outlook and opportunity. I'm a glass half full person. Always have been, always will be, and I've always wanted to serve Schaumburg in a more direct capacity than I've been able to in the past. There's more than one path to be qualified for Village President of Schaumburg, and I think all of these gentlemen on the stage with me are. I respect their experience in this area, and I hope that you'll respect mine as well. I want to, and I'm the only one to keep in mind, that we'll keep out video gaming from our community. I don't think we need it, and I think we can find creative solutions elsewhere. But more importantly, I want to serve you, my neighbors. I want to be there with you on the front lines and be responsive to your needs. So I hope that on April 2nd, or early voting starting Monday, that you'll elect me to be a great steward for Schaumburg. Thank you.
All right, that concludes our session for the mayor debate. Thank you so much, candidates, for answering questions.